I'm here with my husband and my son. At first, I was just going to be assisting my husband with his meeting. I was going to give the health talk. And then they said they didn't have enough speakers for the number of sites that they had. So at that point, I was actually talked into holding a meeting. This is the first opportunity I have had to actually preach. I have listened for many years to my husband, who is a pastor, and God provided this opportunity.
Well, I am sitting here with Pastor Alanima, and we have a team from Global Evangelism holding a number of evangelistic crusades in the city of Dar es Salaam, Tanzania.
I don't know, this is like my first time preaching a meeting, and it's just so exciting because I've preached before, but never in evangelistic series.
I know, you're used to helping dad.
Yeah, exactly, but this is my first time doing the first one, my first one, and it's been so incredible, and I'm so excited now to do it in the States because the reaction has just been so powerful. I've really enjoyed working with the people here, and I'm really excited about working with people back in America.
God perform any miracles while you were conducting that evangelistic series?
Yes, he did. We arrived on Friday night, which where I was speaking was called Emmaus. And when we got there, she said, "We have no electricity." She said, "It's out in the entire neighborhood. It's out in the entire city of Emmaus, in this section of the city." And she said, "What are we going to do? How will we hold our meetings? Nothing will work." And I said, "We're going to pray." The three of us knelt down and we prayed. And when we finished praying, she said, "What do we do now?" I said, "We set up our equipment. We're going to have our meeting. And when the time comes, the Lord will provide." And we got ready for our meeting, and it was 15 minutes before we started. We got electricity, not in the neighborhood, just to that projector. So the Lord did provide a miracle.
You've got a friend in me. when the road looked rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed. You just remember what your old past said, or you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.